Welcome to MISUMI's new 19-minute webinar series. For those of you here that are new to MISUMI, MISUMI is a global supplier of configurable components. You may ask, why configurable? What is it? Configurable components solve the designer's dilemma. A designer has two choices for components, standard or custom. Standard components have limited selection and often force designers to compromise their designs. These many pluses, such as CAD, static part numbers, fast delivery, often seem inexpensive and convenient. The other choice is custom. Custom components have many drawbacks. Designers have to make the solid models themselves in all the manufacturing drawings. Purchasers too can attest to the long wait for quotes, the expensive setup charges for short runs, and the long lead times. We are forced to use custom components though, because of the flexibility. MISUMI offers configurable, which is the best of both, easy and flexible. Configurable components are easy to design with and purchase. Online, select the product geometry desired, the material and surface finish, input the size for each configurable dimension within the range and increment shown. You'll get a smart part number, instant price and days to ship, and the CAD model. All of this configurability is available with our over 1 million components, available at MISUMIUSA.com. Now, I'll turn it over to our MISUMI engineer.
Hi. My name is Yau-Han from the engineering department at MISUMI USA. In this session, we will be focusing on MISUMI's rotary and drive shafts. One of MISUMI's key product offerings is our shafts and rods that differ in price point and tolerances from their different applications. One of the more popular options is our rotary and drive shafts. I will be going through some of the unique features and benefits of rotary and drive shafts offered by MISUMI in this presentation. MISUMI also offers a wide range of supporting products such as bearings, housings, couplings, and many other rotary power transmission components to complement our rotary and drive shafts. MISUMI rotary and drive shafts are offered in diameters ranging from 2 to 50 millimeters and lengths of up to 800 millimeters. Rotary and drive shafts share many similarities, but there are some key differences between the two. Rotary shafts are usually sufficient for general applications and is more popular option of the two. Rotary shaft tolerances are slightly lower compared to the drive shafts, making drive shafts more suitable for higher speed and higher accuracy applications. Many of our customers prefer the drive shaft option for more critical applications, such as direct mounting to a drive source. Drive shafts also offer many additional machining alterations not offered on the rotary shaft lineup. However, rotary shafts are available in longer lengths and in inch sizes. The key difference between rotary and drive shafts is the tolerance range, so I'll begin by reviewing their technical and tolerance specifications. The first tolerance standards I will discuss are the straightness and circularity tolerances. These tolerance standards are very important because it ensures that the shaft will rotate accurately without causing vibration. The straightness tolerance is 0.01 mm per 100 mm of shaft length for both rotary and drive shafts. Please note that our smaller shaft options with diameters 2 and 2.5 mm have a straightness tolerance of 0.1 mm per 100 mm of shaft length. The D-section circularity tolerances can be seen on the charts to the right, where rotary shafts have a circularity tolerance of as low as 4 microns, and drive shafts have a tolerance of as low as 3 microns. Also measured are the concentricity and perpendicularity of the shafts. As per the diagrams, the perpendicularity tolerance measures the shaft's length against the end face surface of the larger diameter. The deviation should not exceed 0.05 mm for rotary shafts and 0.01 mm for drive shafts. The concentricity tolerance measures the difference between the circularity on the different steps of the rotary shaft and ensures that the step is centered properly. An eccentric step is not ideal for smooth operation as it will cause the shaft to rotate off-center. Rotary shafts have concentricity tolerance of 0.06 mm and drive shafts 0.01 mm. The next tolerance specification is the length tolerance that is typically not as critical for rotary shafts because the shaft ends can protrude through a support hole such as a bearing. The length tolerance for rotary shafts can range from plus minus 0.1 to 0.8 millimeters. Drive shafts, however, are normally direct mounted or coupled, so the length tolerance may be more critical and has a tolerance of plus minus 0.1 to 0.2 millimeters, depending on the length of the shaft ordered. MISUMI rotary shaft diameters follow the JIS shaft fit tolerances. The available tolerance specs are H9, H7, and G6 as seen in the chart. Drive shafts also follow the GIS standard and are available in H6 and H7 tolerances. These tolerance ranges are a snapshot of the GIS shaft and housing fit tolerance chart that can be found online and in the technical section of the MISUMI catalog. These tolerance ranges are important to ensure the proper bearing fit for your application. Notice that the GIS standard is called out by a lowercase letter. In the GIS shaft and housing fit standards, the lowercase letter represents a shaft or an OD fit tolerance, and the uppercase letter will represent the housing or hole tolerance. To help you assist in your tolerance selection, you can use this chart found online and in the technical section of the catalog. This chart shows some fit characteristics and some application examples for guidance on selecting a proper shaft and bearing fit combination that best suits your needs. After reviewing your different fit options with the previous chart, you can reference the GIS housing fit chart to achieve your optimal fit required. On the left column of this chart, you'll see the shaft fit represented with a lowercase letter as mentioned earlier and the corresponding bearing fits for the different combinations. This second chart gives you a visual of the kind of clearance, transition, or press fit of the final selection you make. These charts are also found in our technical section of the catalog and online. Now that you have heard about our tolerance and fit selection information, let's take a look at our rotary shaft options. MISUMI offers our rotary and drive shafts in a variety of different material options. MISUMI rotary shafts are offered in 1045 carbon steel and 304 stainless steel. The 1045 carbon steel option must be selected with a black oxide or electroless nickel plating surface finish. The 304 stainless steel option does not have a surface treatment option available. Like the rotary shafts, MISUMI drive shafts are also offered in 1045 carbon steel and 304 stainless steel. Again, the 1045 carbon steel option must be selected with a black oxide or electroless nickel plating finish. The 304 stainless steel option for drive shaft also does not have a surface treatment option available. MISUMI also offers our drive shafts with an induction harden option, as drive shafts are sometimes used directly mounted or coupled to a drive source and sometimes requires extra strength. As stated previously, all MISUMI 1045 carbon steel shafts come treated with either a black oxide or electroless nickel plate coating. The black oxide coating adds mild corrosion resistance and prevents light reflection. A great feature of this coating is that it does not alter the dimensions and does not peel or chip. It is also the less costly option of the two. Electroless nickel plating is the better option if additional corrosion resistance is required, and also offers additional hardening for better wear resistance. MISUMI also offers all of our rotary shaft options in 304 stainless steel, which is our best option for corrosion resistance. This is not a surface treatment, so a key advantage is that there is no potential for chipping or flaking. This option is best suited for food and cleanroom applications. 304 stainless is also non-magnetic. For our drive shafts, we offer an induction harden option that increases the surface hardness to about 50 Rockwell C for better wear resistance. This process also increases the strength of the material for more demanding applications. Now that you are familiar with MISUMI's shaft types, materials, finishes, and basic fit selection process, you can now move to the next step and take advantage of our unique business model to select the exact shaft you need. MISUMI offers many end shapes and features in which the blue dimensions can be configured in as little as 0.1 millimeter increments. Each specification you make will be represented by a digit in your universally recognized part number. This is just a glimpse of the variety of rotary and drive shafts that we offer. With MISUMI, you are not restricted to a set shape or dimension. You can configure each end of the shaft differently with finishes like double stepped, tapped ends, threaded ends, stepped with a retaining ring groove, multiple keyways, and many other variations that are configurable to meet your unique design and application needs. MISUMI categorizes our rotary shaft selections by the different end shapes and features of the shaft, but sometimes multiple features are required, so we offer additional machining alterations to help further configure your shaft to the exact design requirements. This first alteration I will discuss is a very common feature added to rotary shafts. This alteration adds one or two keyways to shafts where they are not already a standard feature of the basic shape. Keyways are used in combination with a key to prevent relative rotation between two components and allows for torque transmission. The location and length of the keyway can be configured in 1 mm increments anywhere along the length of the shaft, but cannot run the entire length of the shaft. The keyway dimensions are controlled by GIS standards, and all MISUMI rotary shaft keyways are machined to an N9 tolerance, which can be paired with the appropriate keystock. The chart shows the dimensions and tolerances of each keyway based on the shaft diameter and can be found online or in the MISUMI catalog. You can also get the keyways on the stepped ends of our shafts. One or two set screw flats can be added anywhere along the length of the shaft. The position and width of the flat are configurable in 1 mm increments. The flat is typically used to prevent the round surface of the shaft from being dimpled when clamping the set screw in place, and also adds additional surface area for better clamping force. MISUMI also offers an alteration that allows you to add two set screw flats at an angle in the same location, configurable in 15 degree increments from each other. This alteration adds a set of wrench flats in a position anywhere on the shaft in 1 mm increments. However, the widths of the flats are predetermined based on the diameter of the shaft. These flats allow you to easily grip the shaft with a wrench when additional tightening is required. You can add a slit cam groove to your rotary shaft to help guide a cam or cam followers. The location of the slit cam can be configured in 1 mm increments along the length of the shaft. You can add retaining ring grooves to many of our rotary shafts. The location of the grooves can be configured in 1 mm increments, but the width of the groove is predetermined based on the shaft diameter. MISUMI always includes the appropriate retaining rings, which are also available separately. The standard thread pitch is always coarse for MISUMI shafts. This alteration allows you to change a thread pitch to a fine thread when necessary. Another alteration can reverse the threads from right to left, and MISUMI also offers an alteration that adds an undercut to the threaded portion of the shaft. From the MISUMI accuracy standards part of the presentation, we learned that MISUMI offers length tolerances ranging from plus minus 0.1 to plus minus 0.8 mm, depending on the length selected. This alteration improves the length tolerance to plus minus 0.05 mm for shafts less than 500 mm, and plus minus 0.1 mm for shafts equal or greater to 500 mm. Also mentioned in the MISUMI accuracy standard section of this presentation, the standard concentricity tolerance is 0.06 for rotary shafts. This alteration will improve the concentricity tolerance to 0.02 and is ideal for applications where it is critical, such as high-speed applications. Just like rotary shafts, sometimes drive shafts require additional alterations to fit your application needs. One advantage of the drive shafts mentioned in the introduction is that more complex machining options are available for our drive shaft selection. The first alteration I will discuss for drive shafts are the threaded ends. This alteration adds up to 3 threaded shaft ends, including 2 step threads on one end of the shaft. You can also select whether you want a coarse or fine thread pitch, as denoted on the chart. This table can be found in the alteration section for the drive shafts. Due to the typical higher precision required for drive shafts, MISUMI publishes the thread accuracy standard rating to ensure proper selection. The tapped end alteration adds a tap to one or both ends of the drive shaft. The thread will always be coarse for this option. Available thread sizes are noted in the chart. Retaining ring grooves can also be added to our lineup of drive shafts. Just like with rotary shafts, the location of the grooves can be configured in 1 mm increments, but the width of the groove is predetermined based on the shaft diameter. Drive shafts have the option to add up to 4 flats at any designated part of the shaft, with the option of having a second flat at the same location in 30 degree increments. The flat location and width are configurable in 1 mm increments. The features of the keyway on a drive shaft are the same as on a rotary shaft, except that the drive shaft can allow up to 4 keyways, whereas rotary shafts can only have 2. The location and length of the keyway can be configured in 1 mm increments anywhere along the length of the shaft, but cannot run the entire length of the shaft. The keyway dimensions follow the same dimensional criteria as rotary shafts. If a set screw flat is required in conjunction with the keyway, you can use this alteration to add a set screw flat at the same location as the corresponding keyway, but at an angle in 30 degree increments to the keyway. A set screw flat for all 4 keyways can be selected. This alteration adds up to 3 sets of wrench flats in a position anywhere on the shaft in 1 mm increments, and follows the same dimensional criteria as rotary shafts. MISUMI offers on our standard drive shafts an H6 or H7 tolerance, which is commonly used in slight clearance or slight push fit. Typically, a stronger press fit is recommended for direct coupled shafts to prevent the shaft from slipping during high torque applications. You can alter your shaft fit with this alteration code. Let's visit MISUMI's website and show an example of a configured shaft. This is MISUMI's globally recognized homepage. MISUMI is divided into 3 divisions: automation components, press die components, and plastic mold components. We'll be focusing on the automation components for this webinar, so I will select the automation components icon. The automation components homepage showcases our major product categories on the left-hand side and subcategories in the pictorial index on the right. For this session, we are focusing on rotary shafts. From here, you can narrow down your search by either filtering down on the left-hand side or scrolling through the descriptions for your exact match. I will select both side-stepped shaped on the filter column to narrow down my results. You can click on the enlarge buttons to see larger pictures of each product or details for side-by-side technical comparison. For this example, I will select both end stepped and tapped. By selecting this option, the site will take me to the part detail page where I can make my final specifications for my shaft. On the part detail page, also known as the configurator, you will see the default drawing view in with blue configurable dimensions. These blue dimensions can be specified in increments as low as 0.1 millimeters for some dimensions. I will start by going down the left-hand selection column and begin selecting my desired configuration. First, I will select a G6 tolerance. For material, I will choose a 1045 carbon steel. As mentioned in the presentation, I must select a surface treatment for the 1045 option. I will select black oxide. The diameter of my shaft will be 12 millimeters. I do not need wrench flats for the shaft, so I will select standard type. Since I have identified enough of my specifications, the part type will appear and indicate in red highlights the remaining dimensions required to complete the part number. Next, I will manually enter the shaft length in the 0.1 millimeter increments. In this case, it will be 147.8 millimeters. The P dimension is the diameter of the stepped ends on both sides of the shaft. I will specify 8 millimeters. For the F dimension, I can reference the drawing to see that it represents the length of the left stepped end. I will enter 20 millimeters for this length. The T dimension represents the right side step length, and I will enter 15. My last selection is the M, which is the thread size for both sides. I will select 6. If you scroll down, you will find that you can also add alterations to the shaft, as mentioned previously. You can then input the alteration value to add it to your part. For this example, I will not add any alterations. After completing all the selections, you will get a part number that is recognized globally. You can now click on the price check icon to find out the price and delivery information for this part. Our standard one-piece price for the shaft configuration is $23.40 with no minimum orders and can ship in as little as 3 days. Next, we will review some customer-submitted industry examples. In this first example, this wire feeder application is driving rollers mounted to rotary shafts. These rollers are being driven by a timing pulley mounted to another rotary shaft and transmitting the motion through the system. This next example is part of the same wire guide assembly from the previous slide. The shaft driving the wire through is exposed to some force to flatten the wire being fed. This is a great example where a drive shaft could be used to withstand the additional force and wear in this application. The final application example is a feeder assembly. Rollers are driven by gears to feed product through the machine. The drive is transmitting the motion through sprockets mounted on a rotary shaft.
Thank you, and we hope you enjoyed today's webinar. All of MISUMI's configurable components and 1 million products are available at www.misumiusa.com. If you are new to MISUMI, register for access to CAD downloads, online formal quotes and orders, and manage all of your account histories. For first-time companies purchasing, you can receive 30% off. Full support is also available. Technical help at engineering@misumiusa.com, customer service at Inquire, and your local account manager at Sales. Facebook now has our 19-minute video series available to view at your leisure. Connect with us to join the conversation and see exclusive content. Thank you again.